Rock monsters, that's awesome. Not biblical, but awesome. Hey, Westside students, I'm JJ, and this is the Theology Takedown. First up, Jonah, a VeggieTales movie.
Who's there? Show yourself! Hello.
All right. I absolutely hate VeggieTales, and this is the reason why. We have Khalil, who is a Middle Eastern caterpillar who's not in the Bible.
You ran from God this morning, and you're well shout tonight.
This isn't right either. He's visited by a choir of cross-shaped gospel singers who preach about second chances against a backdrop of more crosses. I mean, come on, man. It doesn't seem everything right, but I mean, it is classic for VeggieTales. Next up, the Ten Commandments.
I am here.
Put off thy shoes from off thy feet.
Not bad special effects for 1956. The movie only shows four of the 10 plagues of Egypt. Not only were there time constraints, but Hollywood at the time could not recreate some of the special effects needed to show some of the plagues. Yay, God. Now here, Pharaoh didn't die. Some people, there's theologically believe that Pharaoh didn't die, and that was actually an extension of God's grace towards Pharaoh. But there's a lot of people that think Pharaoh was included in the death in the Red Sea when they were pursuing Israel. I kind of believe that he died, but you need to go check it out for yourself. Exodus chapter 14, go read it. Tell us what you think. Next up, Noah. Noah is 500 when he had his first child, 600 at the end of the flood, and lives to the ripe age of 950. So when you're watching this, I know he looks a little bit different, but like think of him as in kind of middle age of life.
Return to your cities of Cain. No, we have all been judged.
I have men at my back, and you stand alone and defy me.
So Tubal-Cain is introduced in the book of Genesis as a descendant of Adam and Eve's son, Cain. He doesn't actually really cross paths with Noah in the Bible, but the film needed someone to represent the evil of mankind that is responsible for God's judgment. We picture the ark as a traditional vessel with a curved keel and a curved hull, when in reality, the Bible simply describes a rectangular prism. I would say I'm not a big fan of this Noah's film. We don't need to put that in there. Thanks for watching these clips with me. I had a lot of fun doing this with you. Hope to see you soon at Westside.